Susan Bradley for CSO Online. Today we're going to talk about ways that we can determine if we've got BitLocker enabled on our machines. But first, a little bit of background as to why this topic came up. Recently in the July updates, all of the servicing stacks for Windows 10 came out with updates to address an issue with Secure Boot feature that may cause BitLocker to go into recovery mode because of a race condition. As you can see in the KB article, our security section for all of the servicing stack, Windows 10 all the way back to Windows Server 2012 all received the servicing stack update to fix this issue. This first came up in May updates when Jody McKercher on the patchmanagement.org list identified that certain updates were causing this issue. If you had BitLocker enabled, you had a hard time patching that month. On some machines, if BitLocker was enabled, it actually caused the system to not boot properly. You had to go and suspend BitLocker and then go ahead and install the update. Now, normally BitLocker is a very quiet technology. It cooperates very well with Windows Update. This time it didn't, and it brought up the question in my mind of, do we have at our fingertips at a moment's notice ways that we can identify which machines do and do not have BitLocker? One of the easiest ways, of course, is PowerShell. From a PowerShell command prompt, type in manage-bde-status-c, and it'll come back whether or not the system is encrypted or not. Takes a little bit of time, but it comes back with the status. And there it comes back with the report of the system, indicating that the drive is fully encrypted. One thing to think about when rolling out BitLocker is ways to help the end user self-recover. Again, not that BitLocker usually has problems with updating, but in case you do have issues, it's wise to have a plan in place so the end users have the ability to get back that recovery key. There's a couple of ways you can do it. If you have Azure Active Directory, you can actually hook it in and have it available all in their portal. As you can see from the Account Active Directory Windows Azure page, my home computer is Azure Active Directory joined, and if I had an issue, all I'd have to do is log in with my credentials, and I could click here and get that BitLocker key. If you don't have Azure Active Directory, let's say you just use Microsoft accounts, those BitLocker recovery keys are automatically uploaded to a live site. In fact, if you've ever purchased Surface devices, you may not realize this, but if you log in automatically with a Microsoft account, those BitLocker recovery keys are automatically saved up in the cloud. You go to account.microsoft.com/devices and your BitLocker recovery keys are there. You may even have recovery keys from long ago devices. Here I've got some old Surface devices that I don't even have around anymore and still have the BitLocker recovery key up in the cloud. Bottom line, there's many ways to control and manage those BitLocker keys. Until the next time, this is Susan Bradley for CSO Online.